Today we celebrate the Ascension of the Lord. And sometimes I think for me it has been a little bit difficult to understand how the disciples took that moment when Jesus was when Jesus ascended into heaven. Another separation. They went through the death of Jesus, they were sad, they were depressed. Now Jesus, he rises from the dead, he showed up to disciples, they were happy, they were amazed. And now Jesus say, I'm going to the Father. Another separation. I think we take for granted and we think that it's easier. We read the Gospels and we don't think too much about what was in the minds of the disciples at that moment. They were so happy. Jesus was with them, raised from the dead, and performing signs and speak to them. And now he's gone to heaven. And to understand, to be able to understand that Jesus say, I'm not leaving you alone. How is if you're leaving us, how you say that we will not be alone? And I think it's the same thing that happened with the parents when they say goodbye to the children when they are going to college. It's not easy. And we say, oh no, we will keep in touch, don't worry about it. Yes, but you cry. You have tears when you say goodbye. It's not easy. It's not easy to understand that. But what is the beauty of what we celebrate today? It's how Jesus believed in his disciples and entrust to them the church and the spreading of the gospel. That, how powerful is that? That someone believe in us and entrust them the gospel, the church. And who can do that? Who is the one who believe in us? Is the one who love us? Is the one who love and trust to us? And that is something so beautiful and powerful that we need to think about it. Jesus entrusts to his disciples. He believes to his disciples, go and preach the gospel all over the world. You are ready for that. I don't know if you have memories of someone who come to you and I say to you, I believe in you. What happened in that moment when someone come and say to you, I believe you, I trust you? How do you feel in that moment? Isn't it beautiful? Isn't it beautiful that? And in the same way, that we feel so good, someone come to us and look at us and I say, I believe you, I trust in you. That I think is the most beautiful gifts that we can receive in life. And that is what Jesus did with his disciples before he ascended into heaven. And some of them, they have problems to recognize him. And why they have problems to recognize Jesus after many times that Jesus appeared to his disciples? Why? Very simple. Jesus is always new. Jesus is always new. And he challenged us because we are accustomed to seeing one way only. But Jesus always challenged us to see more, something new, and he is always new. When we were baptized, We were anointed as prince, as kings, prophets, and priests. How wonderful is that? It's the way that the Lord said to us through baptism, I trust in you. You have the mission to keep spreading the gospel as king, priests, and prophets. He, in the same way that he entrusted and he believed to his disciples and his apostles at that time, he's doing the same thing for us. And the question it is for us today, how we are doing and fulfilling that mission to spread the gospel, the good news of the Lord, the love of the Lord in our lives. How, as priests, we are teaching our children, our friends, to celebrate and to pray. Not only when we are in need, but a prayer of joy and thanksgiving. It's easy for us to pray when we are in need, but how when we're looking to say thanks to the Lord, to praise Him, to adore Him with joy. How we, as kings, are taking care of the world that the Lord entrusts to us, responsible for nature, responsible for our own families, how we govern our own families in our own business and care for nature as God wants us, for us to do that. Prophets is not thinking about telling the people what will happen in the future. It's how free are we to speak about the love of Jesus in our daily lives? How free are we to speak about the joy of what we believe? How free are we to speak about, feel proud of being Catholics and feel proud of celebrating the sacraments? That is the mission that the Lord looking at us, not looking, and He never expects for us to be perfect, not at all. In the way that disciples were at that time, with all the limitations, He believed in them and entrusted to them, go and preach the gospel. Why? Because through our own limitations, He will work through us. And we need to recognize that, to allow Him to come to us and help us, to be prophets, priests, and kings, to spread the good news that the world needs to know about Him, about joy, and about peace. Yes, the disciples were looking up to heaven, and the angel say, what are you looking for? We can look him up, but where we need to see, our hearts need to be focused on heaven, but our eyes and our lives focus in the moment that the Lord is giving to us to be disciples, His disciples, and help Him that He entrusts and believes in us to spread today the kingdom of heaven. It's not beautiful. We need to ask the Lord to give us the grace and give us a humble heart that we, in our way of life, in our own vocation, we can help Him to spread the joy of the gospel. And let the people see that is hope and is a place in heaven when Jesus, our head, is already there waiting for us.